Hey, how's it going? This is Mr. Hernandez, and I am going to be going over some notes on how to solve radical equations. Well, you might be thinking to yourself, you've already gone over this, but it's going to be something more than just radicals. It's going to be dealing with this, but also dealing with this, and dealing with this, and maybe even this. So each of these has this symbol here. I'm gonna highlight in blue for you. This symbol is the radical symbol. Okay, and what's interesting about it is there's actually a missing number right here. There's a two there, and what that number there is called the index. So each of these is called an index. Now one, two, and now one, two. So the index required you to click a special button in Desmos in order to access it, where you went to functions and then you use this square root symbol, but it allowed you to put a three there. And that allowed you to graph this cube root function. Now, the reason why we're looking at these indexes or indices is because we got to know how to cancel them out. So even though this 2 was not showing, whenever you saw this symbol here, you were basically going to put a square there. And so because these two cancel each other out. So, in the same way, because this index is a 3, this is a cube root, we're going to have to cube it to cancel those out. And because this index is a 4, this is called a fourth root, and we're going to raise it to the fourth power to cancel it out, and the fifth power, and so on. Okay, so that's kind of like the new thing we're going to be looking at today. Okay, let's look at our first example. So this is our first example here. Now I'm gonna do a quick review. Whenever you have this radical symbol here, you're gonna want to isolate that radical symbol. So I'm gonna put a box around this. Well, what's in the way of this radical symbol being by itself? Well, we have to make sure we get rid of two things, this plus 5 and the 2. Now, this 5 obviously is adding, and this 2 is basically multiplying. So we're going to do the opposite of pandas, and that's step number one, right? Getting the square root or nth root alone. Okay, so I'm going to work my way here, going the opposite of pandas. And this is something that you guys have seen before, but I'm going to take what we're doing here and apply it to not only square roots, but any root that you might see. Okay, so now we're ready to square root it. And again, this is like a ninja 2. There's no number there, but technically it's a 2 there, and that's why we square it, right? But you're not used to seeing that 2 there, but still, it's a square root, so we're gonna square it. What you do one side, do the other, and then now you have x by itself, and 3 squared is 9. Now, of course, checking it is important, but I'm gonna do that for, well, I guess I might as well do it now. All right, so 2 squared of x. Well, since x here is 9, I'm gonna go ahead and replace that with a 9. Everything here, I'm just gonna rewrite over here. Except I'm replacing the x with a 9. Okay, so the square root of 9 is 3. Well, 2 is multiplying to that, so it's also multiplying to this. Everything else gets brought down. Okay, 2 times 3 is 6. Again, we're going to bring this straight down. Oh, this should be 11, right? This was 11, so I forgot a 1 there. Okay, so, and then 6 plus 5 is 11, And if we bring this down, 11 equals 11, so it checks out. So yeah, that's how you check it. Okay, this is now we have a fourth root. So again, the rule is getting this square root or nth root alone, and then we're gonna cancel it out by raising it to a whatever power it needs. So I'm gonna put a box around this fourth root here. So I'm gonna get this by itself on the left side of this equal sign. So that means I gotta get rid of this plus 5. So I'm gonna do the opposite of adding and subtract 5. So now I could bring down this fourth root. The index is 4. Bring down the equals, and 7 minus 5 is 2. Okay, now step 1 is getting the square root by itself, or fourth root actually in this case. Now you're gonna square or raise it to the nth power to cancel it out. So again, just like this here shows like the way you cancel it. If it's a fourth, the index is 4, it's a fourth root, so you raise it to the fourth power, and that'll cancel it out. So let's go ahead and do that. Now it's going to cancel that out, but because I raised that side to the fourth power, this is going to be raised to the fourth power. Okay, so everything under here is going to be brought down. The equal sign is going to be carried straight down. 2 to the fourth, well, that's the same thing as 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16. And then now we can go ahead and solve for x here. Okay. And then checking it, well, okay, let's do that. So this is going to be the fourth root of x minus 1. Well, x minus 1, if x is 17, that's going to be 17 minus 1. And then I'm going to recopy the plus 5 equals 7. And that's outside of the radical symbol, the plus 5. Well, let me simplify this. So the fourth root of 16 plus 5 equals 7. Okay, well, this really means what number times itself 4 times is 16. Well, you could kind of see this here, right? 2 multiplied to itself 4 times will give you 16. So yeah, this index tells you there's a certain number that's going to multiply to itself that many times to get you this. So that is going to be 2. And then we could just bring down this plus 5, equal sign, and 7. And then if we combine that, we get 7 equals 7. And that is true. So yeah, checks out. Okay, last one. This is the most difficult. Well, here we could see that this is a cube root, and we want to get this by itself. So we got to get rid of this 5 that's multiplying and this 1 that's subtracting. And if we do the opposite of PEMDAS to get this radical by itself, we're going to get rid of the addition subtraction first. So I'm going to go ahead and add 1. Okay, now I could bring all this down. So that's going to be 5 times the cube root of x plus 4 equals, that's going to be negative 5. Now we're still isolating this cube root here. So we're going to get rid of this 5 that's multiplying by dividing. Whatever you do to one side, do the other. So that cancels this out. And then now we have, what's that, negative 1. Okay, now we have a cube here, cube root. So we're going to do the inverse of cube root and cube it. So that it cancels out. But because I cubed the left side, I'm going to cube the right side. So this is going to actually be cubed, negative 1. So I'm adding the parentheses there. Okay, so now we're left with what's under the square, the cube root, or under the radical. And then negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. And positive 1 times negative 1 is a negative 1. So this is going to be negative 1 still. And then now we can solve for x by subtracting 4. And that's going to be negative 5. And just to check it, let's see, 5 times the cube root of x plus 4. Well, x is negative 5. So that's negative 5 plus 4, and then minus 1 equals negative 6. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to combine what's under the radical first. So that's the cube root of negative 1. I'm going to bring down everything else. So I'm still simplifying. Okay, so something times itself 3 times will give us negative 1. Well, that's already, we already know it's negative 1, right? Negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1 is 3. This is kind of weird because you're not used to having a negative. In prior math classes, you were told that you could never have a square root of a negative number, but this is a cube root, which is a little bit different. If you're multiplying it by 3 times, you can have a negative sometimes. Okay, I'm going to bring down the 5. Bring down this negative 1. So this was the only thing that I simplified here. Everything else I just brought down. Okay. So 5 times negative 1 is negative 5. Bringing down the negative 1. Bringing down the negative 6. Negative 5 and negative 1 is negative 6. And that basically equals negative 6. Negative 6 equals negative 6. So that's true. And this answer checks out. And so, yeah, for the rest of these problems, that's pretty much the same strategy you're going to do. If you see a index of 4, you're going to raise it to the 4th power. Index of 5, raise it to the 5th power, and so on. But you got to get this by itself first, right? So you got to kind of move all these things out of here, you know, before you can do the, you know, raising it to a certain power. All right, well, I hope that helps. And, yeah, have a good one.